Hey guys!
Hey!
Children are often afraid of the dark. Believe me, I've done tests. Some of you may have thought to escape your deepest, darkest fears, but were you really meant to? Perhaps some of the Earth's dark, dead corners are best left unexplored. Perhaps there is madness growing in the corners of the earth waiting for... One second. I got it. Waiting for... Maybe you should know everything, but has that stopped your kind before? I don't think so. There is much weirdness in the world. This is unprofessional, and I'm sorry you paid money to see this. There we go. Buy American, that's all I can say. Oh my god. Waiting for the power of these revelations would, in all likelihood, sap any remaining sanity you have left in your puny mind. Oh my god! Now stop laughing. I'm getting to a place, okay?
God.
We'll do it live.
Understand, I'm not here to cause a scene. I just want to have you for dinner with Chianti and Fava Beans.
I have a story to tell you, something to give quite a scare, something old or something new.
Tell you these stories.
Human nature at its best. You must all be very afraid as I invite you to this fright fest.
We have a story to tell you.
Woo!
council meeting underway. I've compiled the issues you all have brought up into an agenda, and we're just going to go through them one by one. Item number one. Councilwoman Sanders noticed a large pothole in front of the elementary school. A lot of parents are complaining that their cars are getting damaged when they drive over to pick up their kids.
That's right, Mayor Templeton. If we fill the potholes when we find them, we'll make sure our streets are safe for everybody.
Very sensible. I don't see why not. All in four?
Aye.
Motion passed. Okay, let's move on. Councilman Johnson has suggested implementing a noise curfew to stop loud parties from going too late.
Yes, I'm all for good fun, but some of us have to work in the morning. We can't have these sick beats dropping until 4 a.m.
Very sensible. You know, if those college students want to rent in our city, then they're going to have to behave. All in favor?
Aye! Those children are being much too loud!
Motion passed. Okay, now I've received a request to gather forth party of brave heroes, arm them for a battle for their very lives, and have them delve into the deepest depths of the old abandoned mineshaft and vanquish the ancient evil within?
It is of the utmost importance that we defeat this darkness before it spreads!
Right, Councilman Versilius, what kind of... Yes, Councilman Versilius the Wise. What kind of evil are we talking about here?
The evil I speak of hath dwelled in the depths of the earth long before the city was built. Yea, millennia before the first primordial man walked the earth. This darkness lives in the deepest corners of thy worst nightmares, finding its time, plotting the destruction of all living things.
Mr. The Wise, that sounds dangerous. Shouldn't we leave it to the police?
Unfortunately, our noble warriors in blue are ill-equipped to deal with this threat. Ever since my proposal yesterday to fly them with mithril armor was struck down with impunity,
it just seemed like a lot of money to spend on something that wouldn't see a lot of use.
Oh, Trixie! Thou hast failed as well, remember? Even after I helped with thine plan for school field trip funding so that your children could go to the zoo.
Well, excuse me for prioritizing education over some fancy shirts.
Priscilla, it's just that if this evil is so ancient, I mean, it can't be that bad, right? I mean, it hasn't even done anything yet.
Oh, Bradley! I should have expected such short-sightedness from ye. Ever since you put forth that disastrous school redistricting plan.
Bus pickup efficiency at the elementary schools has increased by 12%!
All right, everyone. Let's just put it to a vote. All in favor? All opposed? Sorry, Councilman.
Fools! Ye may not realize the danger we face, and ye may not realize it until it is too late. It seems it is up to me, Vasilius the Wise, to gather a select group of volunteers. For I am the last bulwark protecting this town from utter destruction. Oh, God, I'm here.
Jeez.
Do we validate horse parking?
Woo! doll again.
Well, Jim, she likes me better. You know how that goes.
Well, I mean, just about all I can stand of you. Put it up. It's time we duke it out for her honor.
Okay. I'll go first, though.
How do you know, bro? I take too kindly, you take too kindly to my baby.
Bill, what are you doing?
I'm the Duke. Or did you mean both? Look, I can do Ellington if you want.
I should have expected as much from a man like you. I bet you can't even hold your drink. Look, obviously, you don't do this kind of thing often, so I guess we find a different way to resolve it. I'm on guard.
Oh, yeah, wait a sec. Ah, woo!
I said on guard, not on board, Bill. Are you dumb?
Sorry, I don't speak French. I'm an American. Roll up, you know me.
All the napkins! I need them to hear, Bill! I'm afraid there's only one way we can solve this. Draw, you cantankerous varmint! Draw!
You want it? You got it!
Oh my god, no!
No.
Look. Obviously, you ain't fine, much, but we still gotta find a way to resolve this one way or the other.
Whoa, whoa there. Calm down, Yosemite Sam. There ain't no way to handle this dispute in the 1800s. Why don't we just ask my baby doll who she wants to be with?
Well, we can't ask your baby doll nothing, because technically she's my baby doll.
No, she is.
Yes, she is. Yes, she is. Yes, she is. Yes, she is.
Jesus H. Christ, B, look what you've done to your
Mother, please, just stop!
Pete! Just tell me you haven't committed to them yet! Tell me there's still time!
Well, actually, oh yeah, I already filled out my roommate profile.
Oren! You said this would never happen to us! You promised me! You promised!
Fran, I thought we'd be the exception. No family thinks they'll have to experience this type of trauma.
I invited an alumnus mentor over to explain things to you, so can you either pull it together or stop your weird joke?
You invited a monster into our home?
His name is John, he's very nice, and he's going to be here in 20 minutes.
We've lost her already, and we should just give up.
I thought I did everything right. I read all the books. I watched Oprah.
We should have been less present and supportive. We can't control everything.
No, I can still hear you guys. This is a huge achievement for me.
Fine. You can continue to live under this roof as needed, but you might as well go ahead and start planning our memorial service now.
You're not dying. I'm just attending an Ivy League university.
Wow. She became really entitled.
No, B, this is about you turning your back on the family business.
You have broken my heart, B. And how is a clown supposed to cry with a broken heart?
I hope you're proud of yourself, Paul. Stealing the joy from millions of children across Greater Macomb County.
No, not this again.
Ho, ho, ho! Don't you know me, young lady. You know how respected we are in our profession. And you've gone and embarrassed us.
I don't think we're going to be able to show our face at parties when we're in doubt. We're going to have to move. Start over. We're going to have to join the circus.
Well, I think you're right. I might as well just go start packing the car now. Beep, beep.
Off his leg.
the dance and the tango in no time. Speaking of which, I got an update on Tommy Two Tone. Word is, he's gonna be resting in peace at Shady Oaks. Poignantly!
Yeah, yes. Finally! About time to get that old bastard what he deserves!
Yeah, we are really lucky that Medicare agreed to help pay the cost of Shady Oaks' retirement. Now we can spend his golden years perfecting that pit shot on the ninth hole he was always talking about.
Oh, I hear they have beautiful fairways there. And the greens? To die for!
Well done. To Tommy Two Tone.
To Tommy Two Tone.
Bullshit!
Whoa,
hey. What happened to you all? When I got sent away, you guys were all the toughest, wise guys, and now that I'm out, you're all a bunch of city council ass-kissing do-gooders. What the hell? When my crew said they were all at the community garden, I thought that was a bar. You're telling me that's an actual garden? What the hell?
Hey.
You all
that man that just left, Carmine Muscle Scalise. No free cappuccino for him for 1 week.
Woo!
Woo!
My man Charlie. He's a veterinarian.
We've shared this corner at Michigan and State Street for 5 years now.
Oh, isn't that amazing? Thank you for your service!
I'm telling you, man, that was such an easy get. If you just put the tiniest bit more effort into your appearance. Peanut butter and jelly, hold the jelly, extra crust, just like you like. Hey there, sir, how's it doing? Doug Wilson.
Greg Peterson. Doug Wilson? Are you the Doug Wilson that was on Fox Business last night?
The world's most successful beggar? At your service, Craig.
Say, I really enjoyed your segment. Very interesting and impressive sales technique you've mastered. What do you think about coming to work for me at Peterson Incorporated? Could use you in the boardroom for corporate sales.
Well, I'm humbled, Craig, but you just couldn't offer me enough money to give up my begging business, sir. I think I just enjoy being self-employed too much.
Well, if you change your mind, here's my card.
You know, Craig, there is just the littlest piece of help I could offer you with. You seem like the man for the job. Look, I just put $5,000 in a down payment on a house in Sarasota. Looking to also buy a house, Craig. Looking to also buy a boat, Craig. Can you help me out? Please, anything.
Well, I don't have $5,000 on me, but damn it, for you, Doug, I'll go get a cashier's check.
Well, I do take it. I have a credit card.
Oh, look at that!
Yeah.
On the damn ball. Wow! Take American Express.
Of course I do, Craig. You know what to do. Put it in there. Yeah! Do you want a new receipt? I don't even care.
I don't need a receipt. Good God Almighty, you're good. This might have been the best beggar experience of my life. I would kill to have you on my team, Doug.
I've killed.
You know, Craig, one last thing.
Yeah, sure.
If you could just leave a 5-star review on my Yelp, that would be fantastic.
Oh, I will. I most definitely will. You made my day, brother. Oh, did you look at that? Oh, I'd love to help out a war veteran, but just not putting any effort into his appearance or anything. Doesn't even have both his arms. But he doesn't take American Express.
Craig, I've tried to tell him 1,000 times, but he just doesn't have what it takes to be a high-end beggar.
You're one of a kind, Doug Wilson. Keep up the good work, and call me.
You know, Charlie, you always know just what to say in these situations.
Telling my husband now.
Oh, I have good news and bad.
my dear. Oh, the bad news, I've been having an affair. The good news, oh, I'm still alive because I skipped work to be with my lover all day.
God, my wife is going to be devastated.
She'll kill me for not being dead. So what are you thinking of telling her?
That I was really hungry, even though I'd left having eaten breakfast. Anyways, that doesn't matter. I was super hungry anyways. And so I left work to go have a big breakfast with my favorite coworker.
Yeah. And you think she'll believe that you couldn't be at work all day because you needed to eat?
I was really ravenous.
Debris from the building has fallen and blocked the entrance to the only breakfast restaurant near the First National.
Facts. I had to fax some paperwork, and I didn't trust the fax machine at work, so I went all the way across town to this very specific hotel because they have a better fax machine. Yes.
You think that's a better excuse?
Yes, because then at least it's work-related, and it gives me a reason to be at this hotel. I better make sure they have a fax machine here. Hey, do you have a fax machine? Yeah. Have you go down to the party store around the corner. Cool, yeah. Thanks. Bye. Fuck.
Well, I guess everyone will know the truth.
Yeah. Same time next week?
Sure.
Funds during Hurricane Katrina thing.
Yeah, I know, but I figure I'll at least give something to the poor. Hey, isn't that your ex Marge?
Oh, weird. Yeah. Listen, I'm gonna catch you later, Trey. I'm gonna see what's up. Hey, Marge! Whoa! It is great. Oh my God, what are you doing here, you weirdo? Do you work for the executor or something?
What? Gene, my Uncle Pete just died.
I'm sorry? My super rich Uncle Pat just died. Limp accident. Nobody's all that upset about it, though.
Oh my God, well, that's exactly how my uncle... Oh, no. Oh my God. I always knew you were a creep, Gene, but this is a new look. Okay, yes, Uncle Pete did help hide Osama bin Laden for a couple of years, but the man just died. And you coming down here and rubbing my face in this whole thing is beyond disgusting.
Narcissistic much, Marge? Oh my God. Weird that you mentioned Osama, though, because I just found out that my uncle hit Saddam Hussein.
Oh, yeah, he did that, too. Plus, you know, booked private casting calls with
Harvey
Weinstein.
Shit! No! Marge, I'm like 90% sure that your Uncle Pete is my Uncle Pat, that
yeah.
We are cousins!
Oh
no!
God.
No!
Oh my god, I am such
a
cousin!
I did too!
Uh-oh! Sounds like the two of you just figured out the secret family thing!
You really should have realized you were related when you met at our wedding. That's when we figured it out.
And it's not that big of a deal. Our children's inbred deformities are still a few generations down.
Apparently, Oscar Jr. Jr.'s problem, not ours. I don't know how much money it's going to take to make all of this right.
For real, I thought I just had to worry about, he started the Triangle Shirtwaist Factory fire.
I got a number in mind that might help with the healing. And it's not like that much water was polluted when he helped push the Dakota Access Pipeline through.
On top of the whole Exxon Valdez thing.
He was great with investments. That's why David Duke thought he was such a good mentor.
Listen. We're not bad people for being okay with being associated with him. If we didn't take the money, it would just probably go to some charity or something.
Lovely. It looks like the will's about to be read. We're going to be rich.
Hi. Whoa. I'm John Quinones from ABC's What Would You Do? Y'all done fucked up.
Does anyone have any questions?
My parents say you're not from around here. Where are you from?
Originally, I'm from, let's just say it's in the Caribbean region. Okay. Is this the
neighbor? That's pretty cool. Who was your best friend growing up?
Well, my neighbor was Little Flounder when I was a little girl. But later, he just wanted
to... That is awesome! Do you have a boyfriend?
No, sweetie. There once was a man that I tricked myself I was falling in love with. But sometimes a woman just can't be separated from her true self and her first true love.
I don't think we understand.
Okay, listen carefully, kids. Sometimes you can drastically change something about yourself when you're falling in love with someone. Or in my case, think you're falling in love with someone.
Like getting a haircut?
Sure. But sometimes after you've made that big change, you might find yourself in a situation where you really start to question everything, and you wonder if the big change you made was really worth it.
Like that talking head sham.
Precisely. And you start to ask yourself, why did I ever leave Atlanta? I had such a perfect life. Why did my father's servants and I ever make our love affair public? I should have known I'd be banished from home.
Was this guy big and handsome and strong like David Byrne?
His exoskeleton had the strength of 5 red plastic frisbees. He was a beautiful crustacean. He wasn't large in stature, but he sure knew how to make this tail squirm.
Hey, wait a minute. I think we watched a documentary about you.
But from what we learned from it, couldn't you just ask your dad to turn you into a crab?
Yeah, he had the power. Or would that be like burning down the house?
No way. No, he never would have gone for it. When he found out about Sebastian and I, he nearly destroyed his own castle. You could almost call him a...
Shadow killer!
Yes.
Driven in winter before. Just want to make sure we're all safe.
Angela. Angela and I have to be at Metro in 35 minutes. We're going to miss our flight.
Yeah, isn't there something you can do? Can you, like, call one of your Uber buddies and have one of them come get us?
Yeah, like, isn't there something you can do?
Sorry, ladies, that's not how this works. We're just gonna have to wait it out. How about I put on some music to calm us down? Oh, whoops. My fault.
Jesus. You're going to rile my emotional support, Scorpius. I have terrible anxiety, and the only thing that helps me calm down is laying him on my face. Okay, he's doing just fine.
Okay, I'm glad everything's fine now.
How do you think I feel, David? I suffer from internal underarm ingrown hair syndrome. Stressful situations like this make my armpits tingle. Luckily, I have my support beaver, Agatha, to help relieve the discomfort.
Oh, that's something else. Look, it's just too dangerous out there. We can't risk any of our lives. We're just going to have to wait.
David, I hate to be a bother, but I'm a sufferer of low battery-itis, and when the cell phone battery gets below 33%, I have no choice but to bring out Deltron for comfort.
What the hell is a Deltron?
Oh, he's just my 12-foot-long king cobra. I'm at 34%.
You're all psychopaths! How do you function with yourself in real life? This is why I take Lyft.
I'm sorry, I'm stressed. You guys, how do you guys feel?
Woo!
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 So here's what's about to go down, okay? You guys think you're so tough. Think you're a run job. Badasses, right? Think you're so cool you're not afraid of a comedy show? You're just going to see things that students wrote frivolously under the guiding hand of the American wit, Chris Peterson. Music of number by Jeremy St. Martin. No! This isn't comedy! Are you stupid? This is real. What's happening in reality? Are you scared yet? Jesus Christ, you guys are tough! Bless you! Never mind! It's scarier if I don't acknowledge you! You know what? I'm just gonna do some laughs and then you can turn the lights out. I'm good!
Thank you for escorting me, Warden.
My pleasure. Thank you for coming to visit the prisoner in his final moments.
Hi, Chris. I'm afraid the hour is near. I'll remain with you until your time has come.
Oh, you already? Must have forgot to clap a clock ahead last week. But it changed the DVR time on Downton Abbey.
Chris, I'm here to help with anything you need in your final moments. Did you enjoy your last meal?
It was okay. I had the chicken pie from Genovese's.
Genovese's, huh? Sounds like a fine final meal.
Yeah, but you forgot to give me gluten-free pasta. I'm gonna be bound up in days.
I don't think you'll need to worry about... Never mind. Chris, you're about to meet our Heavenly Father for an account of your life. Do you have anything to confess?
No, Father. Just between you, me, and that big guy upstairs?
Yes, my son. Confess to me now so that you don't die in your sins and suffer eternal damnation.
Okay. I didn't much care for The Last Jedi. I can't wait to see how J.J. Abrams saves my childhood next year with episode 9.
Boy.
It's time.
Huh?
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Hey, Father, enough of the bread already. I told you I'm souring.
He just doesn't get it, does he?
Hey, Sue, he's only got 50 bucks.
Man, you know I'm good for it.
You better be. No more extensions.
Do you have any final words, Mr. Collins?
Yeah, me too. That stuff they put in the needle? Any GMOs in it? I've been reading up on the danger of those things. Shit can cause cancer.
Was he dropped on his head as a child? This is the warden? Okay. I'll let him know. Thanks. Well, I don't know how your attorney managed to get you a reprieve from the governor, but it looks like it doesn't end tonight for you.
Oh, it truly is a miracle, my boy.
How do you feel? Goddamn gluten! Killing me!
Deep inside this lonely prison, where the pleasures are so few, where the walls are strong and the days are long and there's nothing new.
You had a massage.
Oh, yeah, I kind of lied on that form. Never actually had a massage.
Ooh, well, that is fun. I hope that this is the first of many. Feel free to take a seat. Are there any problem areas you want me to work on in particular?
Well, my back and shoulders have been kind of bothering me, but feel free to do the whole nine.
I gotcha. We'll be sure to, give your shoulders and upper back some love. I'm going to be over here. Feel free to dress down to your comfort level. It's not like it's weird or anything. We're not cousins. Yeah, what's that?
I do have an unrelated sort of medical issue. It's kind of embarrassing. Don't really want to get into it. Just any unexpected noises from me. Just please ignore them.
I hear you. I don't want to pry, but is this something that could lead to a medical emergency?
Oh, no, nothing like that. I'm sure it's fine. Just do whatever you do as in the Seuss. And just, again, just disregard any noises I might make, okay?
I can do that, Jill. We're going to get started over here with some warm oil and some soothing sounds. There we go. Jill, sorry. I should have warned you. I'm going to start the massage now. Feel free to let me know if you want more or less pressure.
Your nimble fingers please me.
Oh, Jesus. Okay. Okay. Jill, are you all right? Are you okay? You good? Okay, I'm gonna keep going. Let me know if I should use less pressure.
Keep going or your whole family will burn.
this is fine. This is normal. This is all right. Yeah, I'm not misunderstanding the dove. The Jesus. Okay.
Use the oil! Satan is happy as with the oil!
Oh my God, Jesus Christ. Yeah, have all of it.
You stupid man! I will eat your intestines if you stop again. I have seen your demise, and it is sooner than you know!
Buddha, Hindu gods, multiple. Jesus, God, please.
How dare you say that name in front of me?
Jill, your time's up. We need to talk.
He is one of the country's Yeah. No, I really wish I could let you guys out, but I've been doing really well here lately, you know? Really proving myself. For the first time in my life, I feel like I'm going in the right direction.
Johnny, he is going to end our lives!
I know, and that sucks, but it's company policy that I don't get special treatment to my pros. I'm just trying to prove myself after being fired from Amway and Ace All I Do, you know.
No, those are pyramid schemes. You can't get fired from those.
We just have to grind people up into little pieces. Including that thing blows, let me tell you what. But that's not just what Harper is.
Johnny, okay, I understand you need money. Me and Joe will help you out. My parents will get you as much money as you need, but after you free us.
I'm not, it's okay, don't worry about it.
Johnny, I am worried about dying.
What do you need the money for? You live with your fucking mom!
Hey, I live with my mom so I can save money. And I'm trying to save money so I can invest in, like, rental properties. Become financially independent, you know. And then, after a while, I can give back and help the people in need.
Job, if that's what you want.
I need a handout, okay? I'm myself.
Can you? You can't even make scrambled eggs.
I can actually make scrambled eggs now. College was like 5 years ago, guys.
God, and you're still a fucking moron.
But you're our moron, and we just, you know, we don't want to die so that we can spend more of our lives together.
Oh, we have missed you these past years since college.
You guys never change, do you? You didn't support me then, and you don't support me now. I'm finally getting my shit together, guys. hello, Matt, sir. Nothing to see here. Just the next two on the list are my old college roommates, but don't worry. That doesn't, no special treatment though. Mm-hmm. They gotta go in the grinder like everybody else. Some people never change.
You've been a really brave audience, guys. You did so well. Look at you. Oh my god. Oh my god, what tough guys. This asshole took all of the candy from everyone. Oh, how tough you were getting through the whole show that you've seen now 4 times. Really oils my chicken, if you know what I mean. What am I supposed to say right now? I hope that you all were scared, but I can see now that none of that scared you. That was my intention. I wanted you to like the stories and see, oh, what fun. Oh, what scary fun. But now I can see you're all looking at me like, what the fuck is this guy doing? That's what she's thinking. No, I think we've had a journey together, and I really hope that maybe some of us can, I don't know, reach the grave together. You know, maybe some of us sooner than others, some of us disgusting slobs sooner than others. Austin, I don't know your last name. Cool, they're out here now too. Yeah, guys, honestly, it's been such a cool time. I hope you take with the sweetest part of me and have a happy Halloween. Thanks, thanks.
We have a story to tell you, something to give quite a scare, something old and something new.
Good night.